Most Lagosians are united in the belief that Governor Fashola has done very well. What, therefore, are the essential qualities that anyone hopes that Governor Fashola's successor should have?
I know that the people of Lagos State are very, very happy with the way our governor, Babatunde Raju Fashola, has handled the state. He has comported himself in a very, very honorable manner. He has actually been able to bring home the dividends of democracy to the people of Lagos State. We have good roads. We have running water. We have good education, tertiary education, primary education, and so on and so forth. We also have good health care system. The primary health care system is extraordinary. We have our people that are more encouraged to use those health care facilities and also know when to go to the general hospital so they don't have to overclock those areas. But we have to appreciate the fact that whoever wants to step into the shoes of Governor Fashola of Lagos State must be somebody that is already tested and trusted in his own fields of endeavor. Somebody that understands the needs of the people of Lagos State. Somebody that has integrity. Somebody that is God-fearing. Somebody that would make sure that we can see, like our governor now has done, somebody that comports himself or herself in a dignified manner, somebody that the people of Lagos State will be happy that is governing. You know, the Bible says that when a righteous man governs, the people rejoice. And therefore, we want a righteous man to govern our state, just like Babatunde Fashola has shown us the righteous qualities that he possesses. We want somebody else also that would take over from him to show us those qualities as well. We understand and appreciate the fact that Lagos is a cosmopolitan area, an amalgamation of different kinds of people. We have all sorts of people from all sorts of places living in Lagos State. We have people from the north, south, east, and west here. And Lagos State accommodates people. And the population is over 20 million people just in Lagos State alone. So we need somebody that would appreciate the density of this population, will appreciate the need that Lagos State is the center of excellence, is an example to other places. Even if you look at the federal government, a lot of times Lagos State would have done something before even the federal government does it. And it shows that the ever-ready factor in the governance sector in Lagos State, and it shows the cooperation of the people of Lagos State. So I feel that Lagos State deserves somebody that can continue from where Babatunde Raju Fashola SAN stops. We don't want to go backwards. We want to move forward. And I believe that that is a key factor that we have to look at. So we must appreciate the fact that the governor that we would like to take over from our own Babatunde Raju Fashola SAN is also somebody that should also be of sound mind. Because we say, yes, our governor is of sound mind. He's putting a lot into Lagos State. If you look at the past few years of democratic rule in Nigeria, you realize that Lagos State is more like the state where everybody comes to learn. They came to learn the about LASMA, how we have been able to complement the police force in traffic control. They came to learn about PAI, how we have been able to also complement, you know, the authorities to make sure that people stop throwing their refuse on pleasant places, people pack their refuse and keep them tidy. A person that wants to head Lagos State must appreciate the financial aspect of the state, the economical aspect of it, and also appreciate the human resources factor. You have to balance it. You must understand, you know, this are the people in this state. How am I going to use this person to get the right amount of output of anything? And I believe that once we can get somebody that is willing to work, somebody that is selfless and not selfish, because the problem that we have in Nigeria is selfish people. And selfish people tend to enrich themselves and not the people of their country. And we would want somebody that is selfless, like our present governor and his predecessor. I wish Lagos State the very best. I know that APC has done its best in Lagos State, and definitely another APC person will be the person to govern Lagos State as governor. But I wish us all the very best. And as we go out there to vote for the right candidate, as we go out there to vote for the person that we feel will do the right job, we should be more concerned about the state, about what that person can do for the state and not what it's going to do for us as individuals. We should not sell our votes. Because a lot of times, people come from far and near and bring money in and try to buy people's votes. Do not sell your votes. You have seen what the APC has done. You have seen that Governor Babatunde Rajifasola has been able to implement the policies of our party. And it is effective. Therefore, as a true party person, I would continue to encourage our people to vote wisely, to make sure that their vote counts, and to make sure that not only do they, you know, throw in their votes and leave it, they follow and monitor. Because an agent of the party cannot do everything by his or herself. So we need good citizens of Nigeria to monitor our votes, not only for governorship, for presidency as well, and make sure that your vote counts. I wish us all the very best of luck. And I'm sure that in 2015, the governor of Lagos State will continue from what Babatunde Rajifasola has done and make Lagos State even better than it is today.